So dear cadets, good morning. So as you know, yesterday I taught you water cycle. So in water cycle, there was so many processes involved. Okay. So ultimately, what is the definition of water cycle? Circulation of water between earth and atmosphere by various forms of water is known as water cycle. Okay. So during the explanation of water cycle, one important process you have seen, what is that one? Infiltration and recharging of groundwater. Okay, that is the most important thing. So the groundwater as an important source of water, yesterday only I indicated you that groundwater is only the potable water, and most of the animals including human being, we are dependent on that water only, groundwater. So their recharging is very necessary. If groundwater is not recharged time and again, then there would be scarcity of water in our locality. Okay, so before teaching you groundwater as an important source of water, there are certain terms which are needed to be taken care of here. First one is the water table. What do you mean by water table? Just see, what rainwater percolates slowly, seep slowly down the earth. Okay, down the earth or not, after some distance this groundwater gets collected. Okay, so the upper limit of groundwater is known as water table. What is that one? Upper limit of groundwater is known as water table. Okay, now this water table varies place to place. Somewhere water table is very very up, somewhere it is very down, somewhere where the availability of water is more, so water table is very high or very up, while in some places water table is very down. Like just see, in desert areas like Rajasthan and some other places, what is there? Thar desert. In those places the water table is very very down. But in some areas like the Ganga river basin, in those areas water table is very up and very easily we can, means just by digging to small distance we can get the water. But in Thar desert or some other places, desert areas, you keep on digging, so hardly you will get the any amount of water. Okay, so the ground water table is very important. Okay, if you know the water table, then you will go for the digging, otherwise your effort will go in vain. Okay, next one is infiltration. Okay, so water is collected down the earth. Okay, so try to understand, there is a continuous use of groundwater. Okay, bore well is there, hand pump is there, some other modes are also there, by which well, bore well, we are using underground water. So what is there? The water table will go down or not? It will keep on going down, especially when the summer season is there, in the month of April and May, water table goes very very down. Okay, so what is there? Infiltration is the name of method by which rainwater seeping into the ground. So what is the infiltration? The process of seeping of water into the ground is called infiltration. Because of infiltration only groundwater gets recharged. Okay, and what kind of water is getting seeped into ground? Rain water. Okay, so that is why it is told rain is the ultimate source of water. Rain water only seeps and now our ground water gets recharged. Okay, next important thing is aquifer. What is the aquifer? You might have seen that people keep on digging deeper and deeper down the earth. So what is there? Sometime what is there? Hard rocks are found. Okay, what are found? Hard rocks. So aquifers are the places where groundwater is stored between the layers of hard rock below the water table. Below the water table, some hard rocks are there, and in between those hard rocks, water is stored. That is why those places are known as aquifer. Okay, remember, aquifer, these are the places between the hard rocks. And now digging is very, very difficult. And there is no need to dig also, because above those hard rocks already enough water table is there. So there is no need to dig further. Okay. So, and always remember, after the full layer of water, there must be a layer of hard rock. And the moment you get the hard rocks layer, it means digging you should stop, because below that you will not get whatever water you means available on the earth, you have already got. Okay, so this is there. Now somebody asked, what is groundwater? Groundwater. So you can write the water available between the hard rocks and pores of the soil. So water available, here you can write water available between pores of soil and between layers of rock. So the groundwater, what is this one? Water available between pores of soil and between layers of rock is known as groundwater. And upper limit of this one is known as water table. So you have got the idea of these four things: groundwater, water table, infiltration and aquifer. So now idea of groundwater is very much clear to you. Now another point is depletion of water table. Means what are the factors which are leading to depletion of water table? Okay, so now before teaching you the factors responsible for depletion of water table, it is better to understand the process of recharging of groundwater. How groundwater is recharged? Just try to understand. The rainwater and water from other sources get collected in the low-lying area, or it may be collected in the rivers, ponds. Okay? Now just try to understand, what kind of water is collected? Rainwater is only collected in the low-lying area or river and ponds. Okay, now in the soil, what is there? Small pores and cracks are there. Through those pores and cracks, water keep on percolating down. Now water keeps seeping down, and now it will increase the level of water table. And in this way, the water table gets recharged. Recharging of water table means increase whatever depletion of water table has occurred because of the excessive use of water. That water should be replenished by rain water and the process infiltration. Correct or not? Are you getting my point or not? Means we are keep on using the groundwater. So the water table will go down or not? So when sufficient rainfall is there, so that water will seep, percolate, and this way the water table will increase. This process is only known as recharging of water table. So ultimately what we can say, the groundwater is recharged by rainwater only, but the name of process is infiltration. Name of process is infiltration. So these two things you remember, and this is the only reason, that is why it is told that rainwater is the ultimate source of water. Now in this way, today's duration is over. Now tomorrow I will teach you the factor responsible for depletion of water table. Now note down the question. So first question is, what is groundwater? What is groundwater? Okay. What is groundwater? Next question is question number 2. What is infiltration? What is इनफिल्ट्रेशन, इनफिल्ट्रेशन, ओके। सो जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर, इनफिल्ट्रेशन, दिस इज RATION, इनफिल्ट्रेशन। द क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्ड, व्हाट इज एक्वीफर। क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर, एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिचार्जिंग ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर। एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिचार्जिंग ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर, ओके। सो जस्ट रिमेंबर, ग्राउंड वाटर ऑलरेडी आई टोल्ड यू, डेफिनेशन इज रिटन, इनफिल्ट्रेशन ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड यू, अनदर वन इज एक्वीफर ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड यू, ओके। सो दीज थ्री थिंग्स ऑलरेडी यू हैव गॉट द डेफिनेशन प्रॉपरली, सेम थिंग यू शुड राइट एंड दिस प्रोसेस अगेन यू हैव टू राइट, इन दिस वे ऑल द क्वेश्चन आंसर यू हैव गॉट, ओके। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच। Now next video I will teach you the factors responsible for depletion of water table. 5-6 factors are there and those factors are very very important, and question is also there in the NCERT exercise. Thank you. Dear cadets, just keep completing your notebook, okay? Thank you.